do you think about the song Baby
Shark?
My name is Kathy. I run the Dorsal Effect, which is kind of like a shark conservation ecotourism business in Lombok. I chanced upon this documentary called Shark Water by Rob Stewart. Watching it impacted me pretty emotionally. I find that people tend to only have a view that there's only one type of shark, which is the great white shark. But I hope that people will start to see that there are so many different types of sharks as well. They're like the little baby ones, they're bottom dwelling. I mean, they're not baby, but they're smaller. Some of them are reef sharks, they hide in coral reefs. I feel that it's a bit of a misconception to say that all sharks are scary. Most of the time, many of the species are more scared of us than anything else. They have electromagnetic sensors on their snouts. These sensors run down the lateral line of their bodies, meaning they can sense things. They use that to sense things, electromagnetic currents around them. If you are scared, they can actually sense you and they can sense your heartbeat. And if they are scared of you, they will run. There was one trip where I brought the Nature Society people to Lombok where we saw two coral cat sharks that were being sold at the fish market. So when we looked at the coral cat sharks, I saw that their gills were still moving. And that's the interesting thing about coral cat sharks and bamboo sharks and even epaulette sharks. They are very hardy. They can survive out of the water for up to 12 hours. I saw that they had hook marks, but they were still breathing, so I quickly bought them. And it's quite sad because I bought the sharks, each one, for equivalent of $1 each. And because I didn't know where to store them yet, and we wanted them to be in water quickly, so I bought a tub for $2. Like, oh man, the tub is more expensive than a shark, yeah. So anyway, after we bought the tub, it was really heartening because the people on the trips got really involved and they really wanted to save the sharks as well. So we brought it on the boat, and then we went to one site at first, which was quite deep. But the first snorkeling site was, it's not from the shore, it was just jump off the boat kind of a snorkeling site. I took one of the shark, and another boat tripper took another shark, and we were trying to put, like, just hover it above the water to see if they can try to breathe and swim and a little bit. And I think maybe because I was not patient enough and don't know enough about coral cat sharks and never tried rescuing a shark before, I got a bit anxious and excited and I dropped the shark that I was carrying. So I saw it sink to the bottom and I think it didn't really make it. So another boat tripper actually dived under to pick it up again. So we realized that site was not very helpful. So we went to a beach site instead. And then we tried to do the same thing for both of them. So the boy made it from the shore. It's a lot easier for them because they are bottom dwellers anyway. Everybody was very emotional and were crying and we were also very excited and everything. Sharks come in many, many different species. There are like more than 500 different species of known sharks in the ocean. I feel that every different marine life in the ocean has a purpose. So sometimes I feel like to say that sharks are more important than other types of species might be a little bit flawed to me, because the different types of sharks, there are so many species, they exist at different levels of the ecosystem anyway, just like every other marine life in the ocean.